everybody. Welcome back to Heavy Metal Guns and Outdoors. This is a requested video. Kevin wanted to see a little more in-depth on cleaning and maintenance on revolvers, especially a 22. So, let's get right at it. Alright, this one's for you, Kevin. Went through the gun store and picked out a Rexio Fabricate 22 long rifle. Pretty cool looking revolver, but we're going to really get into this thing and just do a real good cleaning on it. First, of course, make sure she's empty. And she is. Alright, let's take her apart. Trying to stay in frame with all of this, so pardon me if I fiddle. Alright, we got the swing arm and cylinder assembly out. Next, we'll remove this side plate. And y'all remember, you're going to work on your firearms. Get a decent screwdriver set just for a firearm. But the screws are different from your regular screws like working on your car and such. I picked up this Winchester set and it's pretty nice, and it was under $15. It was well worth it. Side plate removed. Just screw in here. Trigger. Watch these springs, they can fly 50 miles across the shop. And this piece here, you see, you've got a little spring right in there that you really have to watch. So just take your time when you disassemble it in here. firearm. And as you see, I almost lost that one. Spring is still up in there. Spring is pretty much stuck in there. Alright, next is our hammer assembly. There's your hammer spring right in here. Pull down a little bit. That'll come right out. And the hammer itself. Slide right off. Cylinder release. Get it out, we have a screw in the side here. Okay. Ah, now we've got her disassembled. Everything but the firing pin. We tore it up pretty good. Alright, first thing I would like to do, put some of the powder salt in there. Let it soak while we deal with some of the other parts. Again, I'm using the Pops number 9 powder salt. It's been good stuff. It's done me good for a long time. And I am quite generous with it. See, we got the carriage separated from the cylinder. Well, it just fell out, but I would have it separated. There we go. Then we'll let them pieces soak some. Now let's check our internal pieces. Also, when we're cleaning, what we want to look for is any bad wear, cracks, or broken parts, of course. Fine. Now a lot of little parts, I clean them, I just use brake clean. It does a good job, and it's low cost, and it leaves no film. I'm headed down here to the little garbage can and clean these off. Alright, we'll follow up and clean right. I just use a blue shop towels, they seem to work fine for just about everything. Let them parts be for a little bit. See, I mean, don't take much to get nice clean. Let's get a crane assembly. And yes, we should be wearing gloves while doing all of this. I just happen to be out right now, but I will get some. All right. The side plate. Really doesn't look that bad, but still. It was dirtier than it looked. All right, now we'll dress the cylinder. Got the hops in there soaking. And we'll take our brush, run it through. And we'll get the residue out with some more brake. I want to eat our ejector down in here. Pull the brake clean in it. And I'm going to take my nylon brush and get down in there. I don't really see anything, but I don't see the greatest neither, so better safe than sorry. Alright, rinse it off. Oh yeah, it looks great. Well, I don't know how it's going to pick up on the camera. As you can see, the cylinder's cleaned up very nice. Alright, now next is our frame. What we'll do, all this area down in here, we'll go ahead and clean it first, and then we'll start getting up into the cylinder assembly. Alright, spray a little brake clean on it. Get in here with our nylon brush. Little brush is great, low cost. You with the nylon ones, you ain't gonna scratch or mess up anything. Before stirring all this, I'll make sure that little spring didn't come out, doesn't fall out. Definitely get real good around this fortune cone. Looks good. Let's rinse it off. This down good. I got another clean rag. Now our barrel. It's soaking. So we'll take our brass brush. Alright. Get it real bright clean. Excess on here. You'll see a little bit in there. Brush that again. See a little bit of chunk come out there. Alright, a little break clean. Take another look at her and see what I think. That side looks good. Oh yeah, it looks good. We'll try to get a camera view on this if you can see it. Yeah, look how nice and clean. That's a handy little light. Alright, now we'd normally oil everything and reassemble. But I would like to do a little polishing on this gun just to smooth her out some. And what I'm going to use is my Dremel, the soft wheel, and some Mother's Mag and Aluminum polish. Get a little bit on your rag. Just put a little bit on the areas that you want to polish up. Mainly your contact areas. Remember, you don't want to be knocking off any corners, get carried away with a bunch of crazy sandpaper or anything like that. Just want to smooth everything out. The good thing about using this paper towel to do this with, you have anything with a burr on it, you'll surely find it quick. Frame's got a shade of roughness to it there, so I'm just gonna do a little polishing on it also. Alright. Crank up the old Dremel and get with it. Not applying a lot of pressure. More or less letting the tool just work itself. Crane looked good, but it just to me looked like it had a little roughness in it. Nothing wrong with doing a little extra when it comes to cleaning up. Little polish work will go far. Alright, now we got them polished up. Let's clean them back off with some brake clean. Just a little shot, a little wipe. You see how nice the section looks? Even where the hammer fits on the mainspring, rides on it. Hopefully the camera will pick it up. Alright. Now, we get to put this bad boy back in. I'm using a Hobbs number 9 oil. Basically hit pretty much any point that's going to be a contact point. Yeah, I've been accused of over-oiling stuff, but right there, with them two are rubbing against each other. Screwdriver for me. And just snug the screws up. You ain't got to ungodly tighten something like this here. And then don't slam your gun on the counter like I just did. We got lucky and didn't lose that spring. Let's see if I can get this back in here. Yes! Cylinder stop. Got it installed on the first try. A little oil down there on that pivot. Yeah, it as well. Alright, got the hammer spring in. And I put a little oil on the pivot spot there. Just the trigger. There we go, fell in there like it was supposed to. Got the trigger spring. Yeah, watch out. Got some lint on the little polish wheel, so watch it. Don't get any of that crap all in there. Alright, let's see if I can get this one to go back some. Now, hammer spring. And I'm guessing this is going to be a pain. Bites. You're almost there. Again. Alright. Got the trigger spring in, and yes, I did pause the video because it's a little tough to get in there, and I just didn't want to. You ought to see me struggling on it. Spring won't give me a headache. Well, maybe it will. There's one thing you will learn about working on these, especially revolvers. A little patience goes a long way. It is on there. Right. Got everything on there. It's fine. Of course, you know, I'm going to put a little more oil on it. Another side cover. Get them all started good. Make sure you don't cross the thread. Don't start real smooth and step back out. Try it again. And once you get them all down there, then we go back and snug them up. Assemblies together. Let's make sure it still works and I didn't just totally crash it. Alright, we didn't mess it up too bad. Now, our cylinder. learn. Alright, that's good. Cream, smooth as silk. All right, get out of there. Cylinder screw. There we go. A little wiggle jiggle there to get it to go. Outstanding. Put the handles back on. They sit down in their grooves and don't over tighten. Alright, everything's back together. Locking up good and tight. Outstanding. Get our oil rag. Wipe all the excess on, and also we get some oil back on everything because brake clean really dries them out. Like I say, this rag's got to get a bit of oil on it, so I don't need to use any more. But when I do, I just get these spray cans of rim oil. Outstanding. All right, now we have one clean 22. So now, let me grab us some ammo and shoot this bad boy and see how that functions. Now we've got it all cleaned up, let's function test it and see how it shoots. We've got us some of the Willa 22, just like we shot in the last video. How many times we can miss with this one. got to be these gorillas. Look, it just doesn't want to eject very well. I may need to go to a better 22. But as far as firearm goes, little gun, it shoots good. I've done some single action, some double action. Everything performed just fine on it. And of course, the misses are me. They're not the revolver. Well, hopefully you did enjoy this video, and I know I enjoyed making it. And I sure do appreciate you watching. And please remember, leave me comments, and if you have any ideas for videos, I'll try my best to get them done. And just, like I said before, be careful. Pay attention to what you're doing. Maintenance your firearms, please. And have some fun. Thank you again for watching. And please, hit that like and subscribe button. Thank y'all.